So what was the name of the
Ilui Nishmas? Sibia Chaya.
The Ilui Nishmas?
Sibia Chaya.
Sibia Chaya.
Bas Shloma Zalman.
Bas Shlomo?
Zalman.
Samak.
Zalman. Zalman.
Zalman. Bas Shlomo Zalman. So in Hashem should have an aliyah, or it should be followed by a yerida, not chasulma, but by the emes of the year, they're coming down into the world. So we see that Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai in the periods that we learn the Shabbat. Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai had five Talmidim. And the Rabbi later mentions that they are connected to the five Chumshi Torah. Let's get to the five Torah. Dr. Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai, that he was like the Kuer HaTorah, Eichub Kedusha, but that is five. Chamisha Talmid. And one of them was Rabbi Yosef HaKoyen, I remember. So, he used to say praises of his Talmudim, and he said about this Rabbi Yitzchak, and he said, Ashrei Yiladatoi, happy is he or she, or happy are they, that they gave birth to him. Just the very fact that they brought him into the world, that is Ashrei referring to them. It's more than the tremendous mile that he had, if all he can say is how happy are those who brought him about, and that indicates how incredibly great he must be. You follow? So therefore, we could say in a slightly borrowed way, but in the same general way, about this lady that she had that he was a yid, that he knew how to use money. It was given to him, and he knew that he was a shliya to assist other great things with the money. Because he not only gave it to the shul, he used to give it to other places, generously. As a mele, his mother, she can be said about that happy is she, that she gave birth to such a person. So we see that that's because of the tremendous mile of him, or that causes, as it were, those in the present, and in retrospect, a ashrei. What ashrei means, like a combination of nachas and oineg, and all these great concepts, all sort of linked together, and that leads to ashrei yiladatoi. So, like I said, that's a fascinating remark, which includes both the people who brought him about, or that indicates the greatness of him himself. I think that's a few appropriate words about the lady that brought about this and his mother. It's possible to say that Ashrei Yiladatoi, that happy she is, she had such a man. And like I said, that the more you think about it, it's a very profound implication. Because it indicates the greatness of all involved in the matter. And it indicates that the actual birth of bringing somebody into the world is a tremendous schuz all the time. And of course, depending on what he does with the curses which are given to him. But once again, we see here that the ultimate perfection is that not only you've given koichas, but you make use of them with your own individual, tremendously inherent power. And that's what happened here. He was given good mitzvahs by his parents, but and that is a greatness, but he knew how to use it in the right way. Well, good. So listen, I just want to make another point. That is, tonight is the eve of Teshuvah, B'Sivan. Teshuvah, B'Sivan, that is the day, or the night, that the Frizik Rebbe was arrested. In other words, at the beginning and what you might call the root power of Yud based on is hidden in Tesvah B'Sivan, because that's when the whole thing began. And therefore, B'Yediyah Shalemayla, the Eibush already knew what tremendous implications that would have for not only Yidden in Russia, but therefore all Yiddishkeit from then until B'Yisrael Mashiach B'Poel Mamish, what it would mean. It means you based on it, which means a tremendous opening of all the flowering quakers of promoting Yiddishkeit in the whole world. Of a medal of Fiza, it just shows you that you must never be, how do you call it, you must never be put off by what appear to be difficulties. What appears to be a tremendous setback, if only you just have a little patience and you wait carefully and you study carefully all the inyonim involved, all the inyonim that are occurring, then you realize that it is L'Toivo, but afterwards you're able to see not just L'Toivo, but even Ba'en Aruch L'Toivo, inyonim atum. That we could say is the unbelievable greatness of the Rebbe Rayatz, that he was able to hold things together and he remained with complete awareness and concentration exactly on everything he was doing, even in the most terrible situations, because he knew that this must be only not just a Yorida Tzurich Aliyah, that for sure, but that every prut was only a way to bring unbelievable development and tui into the world. Knowing as he did that he was a Nazi B'Yisrael, Ramele, everything that occurs with a Nazi is more of circumference than what happens by a Ish Ragil. Ramele, we have to learn from that not to be that he could put off by what appear to be difficulties and even things which get in the way. Okay, we see that that if he could have said, well, this is getting in the way, I just have to, you know, throw in the towel and see if I can't get out of here somewhere. But we see he didn't treat it that way, but he stood firm on every point because he knew that this was the opening of a whole new beginning. And therefore, when they wanted to let him out at the end of the imprisonment, they said, you're getting on Thursday night. So the Rebbe said, oh yeah, when does the train reach over there? So the Rebbe said to him, okay, no, I'm sorry, but I'm not going. So, you know, their eyes jumped out of their heads, and they said, what do you mean you're not going? I said, because you even they knew that that could be tremendously dangerous, because in another hour or two they could change their minds. And to wait a whole Shabbos is a whole another 48 hours before they would actually get things moving. Who knows what's likely to happen, you know? Nothing became the Rebbe's here. Which means that the Rebbe was in charge. He was really, the whole, everything was under his guidance. Why? Because he knew, and he brings out that his father, the Rebbe Rashab, spoke to him on several occasions, appeared to him. It's all amazing, that story. That he knew that this whole thing was only the opening of a whole new expansion. And that if he will reveal his oil and his nail, which is oil, maya eleho, then that power will take over, and the inner power of the atom bomb inside the neshama, it can sweep these things aside. And that's exactly what happened. It just doesn't make any sense. I mean, the unbelievable power that they had in those days, the communists, it was just, you know, absolute power over life and death. And after we came, the Rebbe got out, not only got out, but he got out on his toe. He got out on his toe. Yeah. At the end, when they wanted to send him out, he also made trouble because he said he's not going without his forum, you know that. And they had to provide semi-trailers. Yes, yeah, I got a few Svarim. We're talking about thousands of Svarim. They have semi-trailers. Take the Svarim out the river and said, I'm sorry. He said, I'm not going unless I have the Svarim. What do you mean you're not going with it? Yeah. So they called up the big window. You know, they spoke on the window so she could hear what was going on over the phone. You know. And they said to this guy says he's not going with it. So the answer was, give him whatever he says. The Ike is okay. Well, that's a koyach. That he neshama ha'oila me'ayle, and that's what we have to take chizuk. Here at Yehuda, we have to take chizuk. We have to be mishchazik. We have to know that all these things that look like setbacks, and it's all really part of the opening of some new door. And we just have to wait patiently and be strong with that nair, which is working your way, and that's going to light up the way. By all of us, each and every one of us in the Zinyan, and then we're going to stand with the Rebbe, take him out inside the Beis Hamikdash, and we're going to say, oh, look at what we prepared, look at what we worked for, wasn't it worth it? Everybody will forgive me, but I gotta go.
We need to say L'chaim for Rabbi Rappaport's mother, who today is the yard side of the mother, and the importance for us about Rabbi Rappaport's mother is that Rabbi Rappaport in Toronto, he had a desire to take his mother, who became Nifter in Toronto, and bury her here in Spot. So he arranged the arrangements to bring the roof to Spot, and he stayed in the Hotel Hadar, Rabbi Rappaport, and he didn't have any connections here, how to deal with the Beis Chaim or anything. And he found, he met Rabbi Marzel, which got the preface. And Rabbi Marzel helped to make all the arrangements and get a minyan, a cottage, and the grinding and all the things, and this began the relationship with Rabbi Marzel, and from that came this building. So we should say L'chaim, L'chaim, to I don't even know her first name.
Sibia Bas Shlomo Zalman.
Bas Shlomo Zalman. So she should have a big aliyah, and she should finish her aliyah. L'chaim, L'chaim.